three really nice rams to start our Tunis show off this morning. We're just going to use a big, stout, really productive ram to start our class with. You love the capacity of this guy. He's wide tracking. He's got a lot of extension up through that front end. I like his head in terms of breed type. The ram that we've got in second, if you want to get him up off the ground, extend him a little more, you're going to love the design of this guy. He's super extended up through that front end, extra long in terms of length of hind saddle. Another one that has a lot of great genetic pieces. And then to round out our top three, another ram, a little more moderate in frame size again. One that puts together really well, has a lot of ring appeal. Maybe just doesn't have the mass that we see in the two above him. Nice set of rams. Thank you, guys.
Now ready for slick-shorn yearling rams. Placing on the class of fitted yearling rams, first place goes to entry number 1971, Schwartz S&T 2222 Deuce, Schwartz and Tolly Tunis, Justine Biowitz Hunt, New York. Second place to 1975, Busy Corner Farm, 1244, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts, that ram weighing 269. Third place, first and junior show, to 1973, S&T 2231, Ted, Amanda Willard, Northampton, Massachusetts, that ram weighing 193.
A single entry in our slick shorn class, but a really nice ram, really has a lot of stoutness working down that top, a big barreled, big rib guy, a nice ram. Let's give this exhibitor a big hand.
Now ready for senior ram lambs, placing on the class of slickshorn yearling rams. First place goes to entry number 1976, S&T 2227, Schwartz and Tolly Tunis, Justine Biowitz, Hunt, New York, that ram weighing 255. Following the senior ram lamb class coming into the ring, we will show for open show senior champion and open show reserve senior champion ram.
Well, in this group of rams, I think we've got two individuals. We're going to leave them like we've got them lined up here. Just the stouter made one that I prefer, a little more productive in terms of his rib. We get him moving around the ring. He stays a little more natural in his top line as we get him going. And the ram that we've got in second, you love the extension, the length of body and design on this guy. Just like to maybe put a little more product working down the top side of that skeleton, keep him a little more level when we get him going on the move. Thank you, guys, and congratulations.
Our next class will be for open show senior champion and reserve senior champion ram. Placing on the senior ram lamb class, first place to entry 1978, S&T 2270, Schwartz and Tolly, Tunis, Justine Bielwicks, Hunt, New York, that ram weighing 200 pounds. Second place, 1980, Busy Corner Farm, 1251, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts, that ram weighing 190. Class following this will be January Ram Lambs.
Well, a nice set of rams representing the Tunis breed. A lot of quality from our junior ram lamb all the way up to our seniors. There's two in here to me that just bring a little more productivity to the ring that we like to see in this breed. We're going to use the two senior rams. Will be your champion and reserve. Congratulations.
Open show senior champion ram goes to the first place yearling ram 1971, S&T 2222, Deuce. Schwartz and Tolly, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York. The reserve senior champion to 1975, second in that yearling ram class, Busy Corner Farm, 1244, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. Again, we're now ready for January Ram Lambs.
Again, a really nice class of rams we get to work with and evaluate this morning. I think we've got two really stout-made, real functional rams to start the class. I just find a little more product working down this one we're going to start with. Just got a tick more muscling down that top. He opens up into a bigger, more explosive hip. When you get up over the top of him, he moves around the ring very well. I think he gets up here very nicely. The ram in second one, if you need a touch more extension, lengthen them out just a little bit more, you're going to like this guy. Love his head. His breed type is very good. He's extra long in terms of length of hind saddle. Maybe he doesn't have quite the amount of product down that top in terms of loin eye area as we see in our class winner, but I think two that fit up here very nicely. The ram that we've got in third, one that's a little more moderate in terms of his frame size. I like that. He's very productive in terms of that rib. He carries that depth of rib fur back into his middle area there. Maybe doesn't stay quite as level in his top line when we get him on the go, and even after we get him set up in the side, but I think a ram that fits up here and there very nicely. The next lamb we have, done one just real productive. Maybe just a little lower tying in terms of his neck set, how it comes out of the top of his shoulders. Doesn't have quite the dimension in terms of his hip that we see in the ones above him, but you got to appreciate for the productivity that he brings to the ring today. Two nice rams on down the line. Just need a little more product on those frames. Let's give these exhibitors a big hand. Congratulations.
Next class will be February Ram Lambs. And now ready for February Ram Lambs. Placing on the class of January Ram Lambs, first place goes to entry 1985, Ridgeway 2309, Drew Ridgeway, Liberty Town, Maryland. That ram weighing 182. Second place to 1987 Premier 2315, Leah Bewitz, Hunt, New York. That ram weighing 186. And that was first in the junior show. Third place to entry number 1986, Schwartz and Tolly Tunis, Justine Bewitz, Hunt, New York. That ram weighing 173. Fourth, second in the junior show to 1984, Riverfront 301, Jarvis, Amanda Willard, Northampton, Massachusetts. Fifth place, third in the junior show to entry 1981, Victoria Fuller, Valley View Vine, Hawkinson, Delaware. Sixth place to entry 1983, Anna Monique Scherest, Brimfield, Massachusetts.
Nice pair of ram lambs. We're going to start with just a ram that's just a little more pulled apart through the center part of his skeleton. He's more dimensional down in terms of his rib cage as we move back through his body. You know, ideally, we'd like to make this guy a little leveler in his top line, a little freer in terms of his movement when we get him going around. But I think it's just the productivity and the product that we have to appreciate. Both rams are super extended up through the front end. The ram that we're going to use in second maybe tracks just a tick wider when we ask him to go. I'd just like to see a little more product working down the top of that skeleton. Let's give these exhibitors a big hand.
Our next class will be the March Ram Lamb class. Placing on the February class of Ram Lambs, first place goes to entry number 1989. That was also first in our junior show. Red Barn Farm, 732, Colin Anderson, West Carlton, New York. That ram weighing 170. Second place to 1988, S&T 2296, Swartz and Tolly Tunis, Justine Bielwicks, Hunt, New York. That ram weighing 142.
Two nice ram lambs in this division. I think both of them are equal in terms of the product that they have. I think it's just structural soundness that gets this guy. He's a little better balanced when we ask him to go. When we get him on the side, he's got just a touch more turn to that fore rib. I think, and he just stays better on his feet and legs when we ask him to go. The ram that we've got in second, another one you have to appreciate. Maybe just a touch more bone work working down through him. Another one that's got some capacity about him. We'd just like to see him handle those back legs a little better in terms of longevity in the flock. Congratulations.
Next class will be Slick Shorn Ram Lambs. placing on the class of March-born Ram Lambs. First place to 1994, Boulder Creek, 177 Boulder Creek, Penobscot, Maine, that ram weighing 148. Second place, first in the junior show to 1991, Jet, 2380, Autumn Piazza, Wilmington, Delaware, that ram weighing 126.
We'll get into our slick shorn division, a really tall fronted extended ram that stays as level as anything that we have down his top line. When we ask him to move, we may just like to pull him apart right through the center part of a skeleton. But I think a ram that gets up here just in terms of extension and grow power. A little more moderate friend when we've got here in second that's got a lot of power. Maybe we just like to balance this guy up a little bit more, especially when we get him on the move. Like to see a little more turn to that lower stifle in terms of meat production. And then the little guy we've got here, he's a really nice made one. He just gives up a little bit in terms of weight per day of age, a little smaller statured, but you got to appreciate him for in terms of pound for pound. He's one of the more muscular ones that we've got in here. And then to round out our in our fourth place hole, another ram that's got some extension, some bone work on him. We just like to put a little more muscle on that frame. Congratulations.
Next class will be pair of ram lambs. placing on the class of slickshorn ram lambs. First place goes to entry number 1979. Busy Corner Farm, 1246, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts, that ram weighing 145. Second to 1998, Harris, 0486, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts, that ram weighing 158. Third place to 1999, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts, that ram weighing 107. And fourth to 1997, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. Placing on the pair ram lambs, first place goes to entry 2001, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. Second place to 2003, Schwartz and Tully, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York. Third place to entry 2000, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. Now ready to show for open show, junior champion and reserve junior champion ram.
Well, congratulations to our Ram exhibitors in our Tunis category. A lot of high-quality individuals out here, a lot of genetic potentials for the breed. I think there's three Rams that kind of excel in terms of separating themselves. There's two in my mind in terms of productivity and soundness about the ring. We'll go out and congratulate those. Thank you guys for bringing them out this morning.
Our Open Show Junior Champion Ram goes to entry 1985, first in the January class of Ram Lambs, Ridgeway 2309, Drew Ridgeway, Liberty Town, Maryland. The Reserve Junior Champion Ram to the second place animal in that January Ram Lamb class, 1987, Premier 2315, Leah Beowitz, Hunt, New York. Now ready to show for Open Show Grand and Reserve Grand Champion Ram. The exhibitor of the Grand Champion Ram will receive an award sponsored by S&T Tunis of Hunt, New York. The Reserve Grand Champion Ram exhibitor will receive an award sponsored by the Harris family in memory of Peter Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts.
Well, congratulations to these gentlemen and ladies that are out here with our Tunis Champion Rams divisions. A lot of quality in these from our junior to our senior. They're very sound. They're very productive. They've got some substance about them. I think the two that fit me best in terms of productivity that they bring are going to be the two senior Rams. Congratulations.
Our Open Show Grand Champion Ram is entry number 1971, first place in the yearling Ram class. Our senior champion Ram, S&T 2222 Deuce, Schwartz and Tolly Tunis, Justine Beowitz, Hunt, New York. The reserve Grand Champion to 1975, our reserve senior champion, second out of that yearling Ram class, Busy Corner Farm 1244, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. Now showing for Junior Show Champion Ram and Reserve. The exhibitor that wins the Junior Show Championship Ram class will receive a $50 gift card sponsored by Boot Barn.
Well, congratulations to our junior Ram division. Again, nice set of Rams out here. We're going to use the Ram right here. I think it's a combination of growth and breed type. We appreciate the extension that he brings to the ring and the power down that top. Young man, we're going to use this one right here for reserve. Another big middle, really productive one. Congratulations.
Now ready for Best Headed Ram. The Junior Show Champion Ram was 1987. 1987 is out of our January class of Ram Lambs. Premier 2315, Leah Beowitz, Hunt, New York. The Junior Show Reserve Champion goes to 1989. Out of the February class of Ram Lambs, Red Barn Farm 732, Colin Anderson, West Carlton, New York. Again, we're now ready for Best Headed Ram. Our Best Headed Ram goes to our Junior Show Champion Ram, 1987. 1987 comes out of the January Ram Lamb class, Premier 2315, Leah Beowitz, Hunt, New York. We are now ready for the early yearling ewe class. Early yearling ewes are group one. These are animals born September 11 of 21 through and including February 15 of 22. Pardon me, February 5 of 22. The Tunis is one of the oldest breeds of sheep indigenous to the United States. The American Tunis evolved from a number of importations of fat-tailed sheep from Africa and the Middle East in the late 18th and early 19th centuries. These sheep were crossed with some established European breeds to improve meat characteristics. The earliest importations occurred in 1799. They came as a gift to the United States from the ruler of Tunisia and were entrusted to the care of Judge Richard Peters of Pennsylvania. Tunis sheep are medium-sized and are characterized by creamy-colored wool, copper red-colored faces and legs with pendulous ears, and minor fat deposits over their dock area. Tunis wool is a lustrous, long, stapled fiber that has found favor with many fiber and textile enterprises. When Tunis lambs are first born, they are red or tan in color. A white spot is sometimes present on their forehead and on the tip of their tail. The lambs gradually turn white as their wool grows, but the hair on their face and legs retain a reddish or tan color.
Really nice set, a lot of quality in our yearling ewe class. I think we've got some individuals out here in our top five that just bring more back and turn the productivity. The ewe that we're going to start the class with, super feminine front edge. You lock her type and kind in terms of breed character. When you get your hands on her and get her over on the side, this old gal's just a tank. She's got a lot of capacity, a lot of room. She's dead level down that top line. She's one of the wider tracking ones that we have. She's just a really productive type of female. The one that we've got in second, another one that fits the same type and mold. Very level on her top lines, a lot of ring appeal. To me, to get the separation there, she just doesn't handle her tracking in terms of the width of her back legs when we put her in motion. She wants to get a little narrow tracking on that back end in relationship to the one above her. Another big bodied ewe that we've got up here in third, maybe doesn't have quite the length of hip and length of hind saddle that we see. Wants to get underneath herself just a little bit, but I think it's just that rib shape and that volume and productivity that keeps her up here in the top three in a very competitive class. A really attractive ewe that we've got here in fourth. Another one that's extended up through that front end, maybe just a little cleaner up through that head and neck area. I love her for what she brings. She balances up very nicely. Just gives up in terms of capacity and dimension down that top in relationship to the couple in front of her, but a ewe that's got a lot of ring appeal. And then to round out our top five, another one that's got a lot of volume and natural thickness working down that top, but she wants to get off on her back legs when we put her in motion. Let's give these individuals a big hand. Nice set.
Placing on the first class of yearling ewes, our early yearling ewes, first place goes to entry number 2006, Spildy 608, Drew Ridgeway, Liberty Town, Maryland. That ewe weighing 230. Second place, first in the junior show, to entry 2013, Anderson Acres 124, Colin Anderson, West Carlton, New York. That ewe weighing 234. Third place to entry 2004, S. Swartz and Tolly Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York. That ewe weighing 220. Four to 2008, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. Fifth to entry 210, Faustina Jarris, Cummington, Massachusetts. Sixth place, second in the junior show, to 2014, Oliver O'Keefe, Marlboro, Connecticut, with Mum 2218 Remy. Seventh place, third in the junior show, to 2007, Autumn Piazza, Wilmington, Delaware. Eighth place, to entry 2012, Drew Ridgeway, Liberty Town, Maryland. Ninth place, to 2009, Anna Monique Charest, Brimfield, Massachusetts. 10 and 4th in the junior show to 2011, Tegan LaJoy, Gales Ferry, Connecticut. Now ready for our late class of yearling ewes. These are ewes born the 12th day of February of 22 through and including March 22 of 2022.
Another really nice set of really productive yearling ewes we get up in our second division. I think these three, four up here in our top end bring a lot of good qualities about them. The ewe that we're going to start with immediately catches your eye when she walks in the ring. Here's one that's super balanced, a lot of ring appeal about her. You get her propped up over there. She's great in her lines. She's very feminine. She's very angular and wedge made. She just looks like a good productive female. I think she gets up there very nicely. The ewe that we've got in second, another one, use some give and take here in second and third. We're just going to go with the rib and the capacity, just a little wider made ewe that we've got here in second. Would we like to clean her up through the front third of her body, make her just a little more attractive up through there? Sure, but there's no denying the amount of product and the amount of rib that she has. If you like them a little longer and prettier, like the one that we've got here in third, super feminine, really extended up through that front end. She's just a nickel longer in terms of length of hind saddle. We just like to put a little more product on there, but appreciating the dimension that she has. And the big thing that splits this pair is she doesn't handle those legs, feet and legs, quite as well as the two above her. Another really nice big rib stout ewe that we've got here in fourth. Maybe just gets off in terms of length of hip in her pin placement. And then another just nice, well-balanced ewe that doesn't have quite as much product as the ones in front of her, but I think fits up here in our top end very nicely. Congratulations to you exhibitors.
Next class will be slick shorn yearling ewes. Placing on the class two of our yearling ewes, these are the late class. First place to both the open and junior is entry 2021, Riverfront 201 Peanut, Amanda Willard, Northampton, Massachusetts, that ewe weighing 176. Second place to entry 2015, S&T 2244 at Schwartz and Tolly, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York, that ewe weighing 209. Third, second in the junior show to entry 2019, Mum 2258, Luna, Oliver O'Keefe, Marlboro, Connecticut, that ewe weighing 189. Fourth, to entry number 2022, Amanda Willard, Northampton, Massachusetts, and that ewe was also third in the junior show. Fifth place, fourth in the junior show, to Peter Priest, Ludlow, Massachusetts, with entry number 2018. Sixth, fifth in the junior show to 2017, Peter Priest, Ludlow, Massachusetts. Seventh, sixth in the junior show to 2016, Tegan LaJoy, Gales Ferry, Connecticut. And eighth to entry 2020, Anna Monique Charest, Brimfield, Massachusetts.
Now, the nice set of females in our slick shorn division. We've got two just really productive ewes up here. I think it's just total rib volume and capacity and shape. I like that about our class winner. Moves around the ring very freely. The ewe that we've got here in second, another one that's got a lot of extension, a lot of capacity as well. Maybe it might not have quite as much product working down that top, but you have to grant her that being just a little neater in terms of how that blade ties into the front part of her skeleton. Nice pair up here in our first and second place hole. The ewe that we've got here in third, another just real productive ewe. Maybe doesn't come out of her hip as square and dimensional as the two above her. And then the next ewe that we've got here in fourth, another one that's got a lot of rib shape, just very productive type of ewe. We just like to change and pull that pin set apart. Same for the ewe that we've got in fifth. Big rib, just like to give them a little more stoutness out through the top end of that skeleton. Congratulations.
Next class is pair of yearling ewes. Pair yearling ewes, your next class. Placing on the slick shorn yearling ewe class for our Tunis show, first place goes to entry number 2024, S&T 2215, Schwartz and Tolly Tunis, Justine Bielwick, Hunt, New York, that ewe weighing 208. Second place to 2025, Busy Corner Farm, 1226, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts, that ewe weighing 201. Third, first in the junior show, to entry 2028, S&T 2233, Leah Bielwitz, Hunt, New York, that ewe weighing 195. Fourth place, to entry 2026, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. Fifth, to entry number 2027, also Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. next class is Senior Ewe Lambs. Senior Ewe Lambs will be your next class. Placing on the pair of yearling ewe class, first place goes to entry 2041, Amanda Willard, Northampton, Massachusetts. Second place to 2040, Schwartz and Tolly Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York. Third to entry 2038, Drew Ridgway, Libertytown, Maryland. Fourth place to 2035, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. Fifth place to 2036, Oliver O'Keefe, Marlboro, Connecticut. Sixth place to 2037, Peter Priest, Ludlow, Massachusetts. Seventh place to 2033, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. Eighth place to entry 3034, Tegan LaJoy, Gales Ferry, Connecticut. And nine to entry 2032, Anna Monique Sherest, Brimfield, Massachusetts. Again, now ready for Senior Ewe Lambs. Currently showing Senior Ewe Lambs, your next class will be for Open Show Senior Champion and Reserve Senior Champion Ewe. Here's the first Tunis trivia question. At the 2022 Northeast Regional Tunis Show at the Big E, who exhibited the best-headed Tunis ewe? Very good, Aaron. That was really quick. Aaron Liu from Massachusetts had it with a slick-shorn yearling ewe. Got a bonus here, so we'll do another one. At the 2018 Northeast Regional Tunis Show at the Big E, who exhibited the first place exhibitor's flock and first place breeder's flock? 2018. One hint, they're not exhibiting this year. Nancy got that. It was Double Trouble Tunis, the Kyle sisters, Brooke and Emma Kyle from New York.
Nice class of long ewe lambs. When we get in here and get to evaluating these, I think we've got five individuals in this class that all have a lot of quality. They're all very productive in terms of their rib type and their body conformation. The ewe that we get in here in class that I'm going to start with just kind of holds everything together when we get her moving around the ring. She moves super good on her feet and legs. And when you get a hold of her, here's the one that's got the most product working down her top in terms of dimension. Down that top side part of her skeleton, through that loin, and out through a very super wide, big pin set on her. The ewe that we've got in second, another one that I appreciate for the dimensions. Maybe just gets a little rounder out there through the point of her shoulder, but I appreciate the rib and the dimension that she has. The ewe that we've got in third, here's another really big volume ewe. Has got a really nice ring appeal look to her side, but when you get your hands on her, she tends to be one of the shorter made, shorter hind saddled ones in the class that just doesn't function quite as well. And when we ask her to go. And then in fourth place, we've got one that's just a little more refined, very attractive up through that front end, very feminine in her design. We just like to pull her apart and stouten her up just ever so slightly. And then to round out our top five, just another really productive rib kind of ewe that just needs a little more size and scale. Congratulations.
Again, now ready to show for open show senior champion and reserve senior champion you. Placing on the senior U lamb class, first place goes to entry 2044, S&T 2278, Schwartz and Tully, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York, that U weighing 167. Second place to entry 2045, Spildy 699, Drew Ridgeway, Liberty Town, Maryland, that U weighing 174. Third to entry 2043, Drew Ridgeway, Liberty Town, Maryland, Nat U weighing 175. Fourth place to entry number 2046, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. Fifth, first in the junior show to entry 2042, MB 2211F, Autumn Piazza, Wilmington, Delaware.
Well, a really impressive lineup when we get all of our females of each respective division out here. Super good in terms of the genetic potential for our Tunis. A lot of productivity about here. You get excited, you know, looking across breeds. All of these in this particular breed have a lot of desirable traits in terms of femininity. They've got some rib shape. They're stout made. And then we bring them into the show ring. They still have a lot of ring appeal. Now, there's a couple that, to me, for what I'm looking at in terms of productivity, ability to get out there and hustle and raise a lamb, have some functionality. They're good on their feet and legs. I think there's two in this division that rise to the top. Let's congratulate them. We'll go out and select your champion female for this division.
Open show senior champion U goes to first place early yearling U 2006 Speldy 608 Drew Ridgeway Liberty Town Maryland. The reserve senior champion to our class winner from the senior U lamb class 2044 S&T 2278 Schwartz and Tolly Tunis Justine Bielwitz Hunt New York. Now ready for January, you lambs.
Well, we just keep getting nice ones. We've got out here in our ULAM class. I think we've got five out here that are just really attractive. The ewe that we're going to start with, to me, just kind of has a little more power and a little more mass. She puts together everything when we ask her to go. She's good on her feet and legs. She's got some product working down the top side of her skeleton, and we get her propped up here on the side. So she's not wanting to cooperate right now, but probably her best look is when we've got her in motion. She really comes together. A really attractive ewe that we've got here in second, one that's got a lot of ring appeal from the side. We'd like to just ease her out in terms of her skeleton. When we ask her to get up and go, she wants to get a little tighter in her movements, maybe just a touch straighter, and now that blade ties into the front part of her skeleton. Probably the reason that she wants to get a little higher in her top line when we get her walking. Just a solid foundation ewe that we've got here in third. She's not longest, the biggest, or anything like that. She's just very, very complete, and I think she fits up here in terms of balance and structural soundness as well as anything that we have in the class. A little bigger framed, a bigger ribbed ewe. We just like to take and stretch her out. When you get your hands on her, you're a little surprised. She tends to be one of the shorter hind-saddled, shorter hip sheep that we've got in the class. But I think she fits up here very nicely, just pure in terms of rib shape and productivity. And then just another real tall, extended feminine ewe to round out our top five. Congratulations to you guys.
Now ready for February, you lambs. Placing on the January class of ewe lambs, first place goes to entry number 2053, Busy Corner Farm, 1253, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. That ewe weighing 141, second place. To entry number 1996, S&T 2293, Schwartz and Tully, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York. That ewe weighing 125. Third place to entry number 2054, Schwartz and Tully, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York. That ewe weighing 128. Fourth place to entry 2050, Drew Ridgway, Liberty Town, Maryland. Fifth place to 2048, Drew Ridgway, Liberty Town, Maryland. Sixth place to, and first in the junior show, to 2056, Fuller, 0087, Victoria Fuller, Valley View Vine, Hokesson, Delaware. 7, second in the junior show, to 2057, Piazza, 0052, Autumn Piazza, Wilmington, Delaware. 8, third in the junior show, to 2049, Amanda Willard, Northampton, Massachusetts. 9 to entry 2052, Anna Monique Charest, Brimfield, Massachusetts. And 10 to entry 2047, Anna Charest, Brimfield, Massachusetts.
Another really competitive class, and when we get in here, this class gets a lot of fun to judge because there's some really nice ones up in here. You can flip-flop these top two, but they're really, really, really nice. All three of them fit up here very nicely, and when you're a judge and like to try to set a pattern, this was a really neat class to try to do that, and so we'll talk through them a little bit. I think the me that we start the class with, just when you get your hands on them, all three of these ewes we've got up here in the top are extremely attractive, a lot of ring appeal when we get them set up, as well as when they're on the move. I think the one that we're going to use when I get my hands on her, she's just a little more powerful in terms of her skeletal dimension down that top and then through, just a super wide, really big hip on this female. Is she quite as elevated in through her chest floor as a ewe in second? No, but I think it gets really close in this pair. The ewe that we've got in second, I love the femininity about her. She's super pretty in terms through up front end, but when you get your hands on her, she just runs out of power in terms of hip placement and pin placement compared to our class winner. That's being really picky on a really attractive ewe. Really a long-sided, attractive one that's probably the most up-fronted, really cool in terms of how her front end ties into the rest of her body. You know, if you want one that's just pure eye appeal and ring appeal, you're going to like the one that I've got here in third. Beautiful in terms of rib shape. She's more desirable how her chest floor ties in up through the center part of her skeleton and up through the top of her neck. Very attractive female. To me, I'd just like to see a little more power working down that top line, but three awfully and awfully nice ewes. Then we get into the ewe in fourth, another ewe that's got a lot of good about her. She just runs out of power down that top. She wants to get just a little narrow, maybe not quite as attractive from the side, but another one that's got a lot of productivity about her. Same thing for the ewe that we've got to round out our division, just a really big hip ewe that we just like to take and stretch out in terms of how she's put together in her stride and her skeleton. Nice class of ewes, really impressive top three. Congratulations to these exhibitors.
Now ready for March-born ewe lambs. Placing on the February class of ewe lambs, first place in open and in junior goes to 2068, Anderson Acres, 136, Colin Anderson, West Carlton, New York, that ewe weighing 135. Second to entry 2069, S&T 2297, Schwartz and Tully, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York, that ewe weighing 129. Third, second in the junior show to 2059, Kyle, 2367, Colin Anderson, West Carlton, New York, that ewe weighing 127. Fourth, third in the junior show to lot number 2058, Oliver O'Keefe, Marlboro, Connecticut. Fifth place to entry 2065, Drew Ridgway, Liberty Town, Maryland. Sixth place to 2064, Drew Ridgway. Seventh to entry number 2060, and that's fourth in the junior show, Victoria Fuller, Valley View Vine, Hokesson, Delaware, 8th to entry 2066, Anna Monique Charest, Brimfield, Massachusetts, 9, 5th in the junior show to 2061, Autumn Piazza, Wilmington, Delaware, and 10th to entry 2062, Deborah Fuller, Hokesson, Delaware.
Three nice March ewe lambs. Ewe lamb I want to start with, just got a little more productivity about her in terms of her shape to the rib, extension up through that front end. You like the way she moves around the ring. I think she gets up here very nicely. Kind of pick your types that we have, a little longer, more extended ewe that's a little freer moving here in second, and then a ewe in third, a really big ribbed ewe that we just like to take and extend a little bit. She wants to be just a tick shorter in terms of her makeup. Nice set. Congratulations to you guys.
Next class is slickshorn ewe lambs. Placing on the class of March ewe lambs, first place to entry 2077, Boulder Creek 179, Boulder Creek, Penobscot, Maine, that ewe weighing 113. Second place to entry 2070, Busy Corner Farm 1258, Boulder Creek, Penobscot, Maine, that ewe weighing 97. Third place, first in the junior show, to entry number 2075, Riverfront 303, Cortona, Amanda Willard, Northampton, Massachusetts, that ewe weighing 106. At the 2008 Northeast Regional Tunis Show at the Big E, who exhibited the Grand Champion Ram, First Place Breeders' Flock, First Place Exhibitors' Flock, and was awarded Premier Exhibitor and Premier Breeder honors? Debbie got that right away. Joe and Joan CB from New York. Let's go here. While Joe and Joan CB had the Grand Champion Ram at the 2008 Northeast Regional Tuna Show at the Big E, who had the Grand Champion U? Debbie got that? Oh, Nancy got it. Josie Best of New Hampshire. Speaking of Josie, she had a pretty good day in 2013 at the Tuna Show here at the Big E. She didn't have the Grand Champion Ram, and she didn't win the two flock classes, though. Who was the exhibitor who did have that Grand Champion Ram and was first in both flocks? And that person is not showing here this year.
Well, we get into our slick shorn division, the two up here that we've get in the top of the class, just have a little more power, a little more shape to them, a little more productivity in terms of rib and capacity. I think they get up here very nicely. The U that we've got here in third, another one that's got some value to her in terms of length of body and rib shape. We just like to make a little more curvature to that lower leg. And then the U that we've got here in fourth, another one that's got some good rib to her. She's going to be a productive U. Again, we would just like to put a little more ring appeal and balance them up. Same thing for the two on down. Nice functional females, just need a little more balance in terms of getting into the show ring. Congratulations.
Our next class will be a pair of ewe lambs. The answer to that complicated question I asked about 2013, about who did have the two flock class winners and also Grand Champion Ram, it was Wendy Cameron. Placing on the class of slick shorn ewe lambs, first place goes to entry 2079, S&T 2274. Schwartz and Tully, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York, that ewe weighing 166. Second place to entry 2080, Busy Corner Farm, 1249, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts, that ewe weighing 130. Third place to entry number 2055, Deborah Fuller, Hockessin, Delaware, that ewe weighing 117. Fourth place to entry 2082, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. Fifth, first in the junior show, to 2078, Busy Corner, 1247, Adam Jarrus, Cummington, Massachusetts. Sixth place to entry number 2081, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. Placing on the pair of ewe lamb class, first place goes to Colin Anderson, West Carlton, New York. Second place to Schwartz and Tully, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York. Third to Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. Fourth place, Drew Ridgway, Libertytown, Maryland. Five, Troy Staples, Penobscot, Maine. Sixth place to Amanda Willard, Northampton, Massachusetts. Seven, Victoria Fuller, Hockessin, Delaware. Eighth place, Autumn Piazza, Wilmington, Delaware. Nine to Deborah Fuller, Hockessin, Delaware. 10, Anna Charest, Brimfield, Massachusetts. And 11, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. Now showing for open show, junior champion U and reserve. Here is the final Big E Tunis question, and you got to go back a little bit. The Big E was the host to the 1998 National Tunis Show, who exhibited the Grand and Reserve Grand Champion Ram, Grand and Reserve Grand Champion U. They are showing here this year. It was Schwartz and Tolly Tunis of New York.
Well, in this junior division, it's been a lot of fun to judge. We've had a lot of quality all morning out here in the Tunis show, from our Slick Shorn all the way up to our older ULAM down here on the end. Again, there are two that really were attractive, that put a lot of things together for me in the ring today. One of the tougher decisions, we're going to stay with that. These two ewes right here, you're going to be your champion reserve. Congratulations.
.2068, our first place February ewe lamb was our junior champion ewe. Anderson Acres, 136, Colin Anderson, West Carlton, New York. The reserve junior champion was second in that February class, 2069. S&T 2270-97, Schwartz and Tully, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz of Hunt, New York. Now ready to show for Grand and Reserve Grand Champion, you. The award for Grand Champion, you, is given by Oliver O'Keefe, Marlboro, Connecticut, and the Reserve Grand Champion U Award from Boulder Creek Farm, Penobscot, Maine.
Well, congratulations to our champions out here in this drive. Four really impressive Tunis females that we get to evaluate out here today. It's been a great time for me to get to judge up here. I appreciate the opportunity. While we're still here waiting, let's put our hands together for the staff back here for making this show run so smooth. They do an exceptional job. And I know they probably get more butt chewings than they do thank yous, and they put a lot of time and effort into doing this. So, again, been a great time. We'll go out here and select the champion ewes. Super in terms of productivity. This division has been a lot of fun to judge. Congratulations to you guys.
Our open show Grand Champion U is 2068. 2068 was our junior champion U. The junior champion U coming out of the February U Lamb class, Anderson Acres, 136. Colin Anderson, West Carlton, New York. The reserve grand champion was our reserve junior champion U, 2069 on the entry book. 2069 was second in the February ULAM class, S&T 2297, Schwartz and Tully, Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York. We are ready to show for reserve junior show champion U, as our grand champion U is also our junior show champion U. So we need 2013 Anderson Acres, 124 of Colin Anderson's out of the year, early yearling U class. We need 2021 Riverfront, 201 Peanut from Amanda Willard from the late yearling U class. We need 2028 S&T 2233 of Leah Bielwitz out of the slick shorn yearling U class. We need 2042 from the MB2211F from the senior U Lamb class of Autumn Piazza. We need 2056 Fuller, 80087 Victoria Fuller from the January ULAM class. We need 2059 Kyle, 2367 from Colin Anderson from the February ULAM class, second place. We need 2075 Riverfront, 303 from Amanda Willard from the March class, and we need 2078 Busy Corner, 1247 Adam Jarrus from the Slick Shorn ULAM class. These are to show for reserve champion junior show U. Following this, we will show best headed U. Our junior show champion received a $50 gift card from Boot Barn. And again, that was 2068. Our junior champion and our overall grand champion U. Next year's, the 2024 National Tuna Show will be at the Maryland State Fair. Our junior show reserve champion U was entry 2021 out of the late yearling U class, Riverfront 201 Peanut, Amanda Willard, Northampton, Massachusetts. Now ready to show for best headed U. The exhibitor with the best headed U will receive an award from Busy Corner Farm, Cummington, Massachusetts. They also gave the Best Headed Ram Award. And our best headed ewe goes to our class winner from the January ewe lamb class. Entry 2053, Busy Corner Farm, 1253, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. We are now ready for Exhibitor's Flock. Exhibitor's Flock. Placing on the exhibitor's flock, first place goes to Schwartz and Tolly Tunis, Justine Bielwitz, Hunt, New York. Second place to Drew Ridgway, Liberty Town, Maryland. Third place, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. Four, Amanda Willard, Northampton, Massachusetts. Fifth, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. And sixth, Anna Scherest, Brimfield, Massachusetts. Next class, Breeders' Flock. Placing on the breeder's flock, first place to Schwartz and Tully Tunis, Justine Bewitz, New Hunt, New York. Second to Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. Third, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. And four, Anna Charest, Brimfield, Massachusetts. Now ready for Get of Sire. Placing on the Get of Sire class, first goes to Schwartz and Tully Tunis, Justine Bewitz, Hunt, New York. Second, Aaron Liu, Cummington, Massachusetts. Third place, Kyle Harris, Ludlow, Massachusetts. And four, to Anna Charest of Brimfield, Massachusetts. At this time, we need a representative of S&T Tunis to come to the show ring. And we'd like to congratulate Justine Bewitz, S&T Tunis, for winning the Premier Exhibitor and Premier Breeder Award at this year's Regional Tunis Show. That does conclude our Tunis Show for this morning. Our judge has been Sean Ramsey of College Station, Texas. We will be back in the ring at 1 o'clock for our National Lincoln Show.